Hello friends, this video on electrostatic potential part 9 is brought to you by examfear.com. No more fear from exam. Please make sure that you have watched all the videos till part 8 before going ahead with part 9. Now let us look at the potential at a point due to a system of charges. There we saw it was due to a single point charge. Now we will see what will happen if there are several charges in a system. So what would be the potential at a point because of so many charges? So let us suppose we have a particular charge, say Q1. So let us suppose we have a system of charges. As you can see here, there are multiple charges, right? So let us suppose we have some point. Let us say this Q1. I'm sorry, this is by mistake, it is written as Q1. Let us say this is a point O. This is not a charge, right? This is a point O, and these are the various charges which are located here. So you have to calculate the potential at this point O. At this point, you have to calculate the value of potential, that is the net potential at this point, due to so many charges, due to a system of charges. So let us suppose the position vectors of each of these points is given by R1, R2, R3, R4. So these all denotes the position vectors of each of these points. Right? So what happens to the potential at point O? So potential at point O due to the charge Q2 becomes what? It is similar to the potential due to a point charge. So this becomes KQ by R. So Q is Q2 here. So it is KQ2 by R2. Right? This is R2, this is R3, this is R4, and this is R5. Okay, so this becomes similarly potential at point O due to the charge Q3. It becomes KQ3 divided by R3. Similarly, potential due to charge 4, it becomes KQ4 divided by R4, and so on. So what do we see? What is the net potential at point O? So the net potential would be the sum of these potentials, because here there is no vector addition, there is no concept of direction at all, because potential is not a vector quantity. So only magnitude matters. So whenever you have to calculate the total potential at some point, it will be the algebraic sum of all the potential at that point due to the different charges. So the net potential will be equal to potential due to 2 plus potential due to 3 plus potential due to 4 plus potential due to 5. So in short or in general, we can say that net potential due to a system of charges is the summation of the potential due to individual charges, that is summation of KQI divided by RI, where I is anything from 1 to n. So whenever you have multiple charges forming a system, then the potential due to the multiple charges is equal to the sum of the potentials due to each individual charge. So that is how you calculate the potential. Thank you. Please visit examfear.com to watch free educational videos, try free online tests, get the best quality study materials, study from the best tutors and mentors, and much more. Thank you once again.